For next Friday, Jerry Lewis is joined by his partner in many a film, Dean Martin, as two ill-matched city boys turned cowboys in a crazy tale of the Wild West. Partners, at 6 next Friday. At 7:20, 25 years ago, BBC Two was finally launched. There now follows a taste of the material transmitted in the first week, including some rare footage of an obscure BBC Two presenter, Reginald Atkinson, who was in fact dismissed immediately after his first broadcast.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to BBC Two. My name is Reginald Atkinson, welcoming you to the second television channel of the British Broadcasting Corporation. Now, as you may know, we were intending to commence transmission last night, but there was a fire at the Battersea Power Station that plunged the whole of West London into darkness, including us all here at Television Centre. Suddenly at 7 o'clock, you literally couldn't see your hand in front of your face. Speaking entirely for myself, I didn't have my hand in front of my face. So, you know, I wouldn't have seen it, even if the lights had been on. Nevertheless, we weren't able to bring you any programmes, and for that, I'd like to apologise. Now, if you're watching this programme now, you must have bought a new 625-line television set and aerial, which, as you know, costs around £90. So, I shouldn't really say good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I could be more specific and say good evening, rich people. And thank you for being so rich. Otherwise, we wouldn't have anyone watching us at all. Sadly, also, we have only one transmitter, and that's in the south of England. So if you're watching this programme and you're from north of Huntingdon, then you must be on holiday. Either that, or you're hallucinating. And if you're able to see us in colour, then you certainly are hallucinating. Colour transmission will not begin until 1967 at the earliest. But for those of you who are interested, I am in fact wearing a grey suit and a red tie. Well, one day late, Channel 2 is on the air, and everyone here is terribly excited. I know there's one little chap who missed our opening and his Uncle Reginald last night, and that's my nephew, Rowan. There he is. He's only 9. He was in his own production last week at his primary school of The Old Lady Who Lived in the Shoe, playing a strolling tinker. I think he created a comedy role for himself. Apparently his zanny humour was very much enjoyed. Who knows, one day he might make it onto BBC Two. Well, that's enough from me. I leave you in the capable hands of Dennis Toohey, and I hope you enjoy all the riches that this channel intends to bring you in the years ahead. Thank you. Oh, by the way, I was lying. Just my little joke. I'm in fact wearing a green suit and a blue tie. Thank you.
Good evening. This is BBC Two.
This opening program of Channel Two is coming from the Alexandra Palace newsroom, owing to a massive electric failure at the television centre in West London. Excuse me, just like Channel One.
Hello?
Unlike Channel One, there's nobody there. As you can imagine, there's a good deal of rushing about going on behind the scenes.
Fella Shakespeare was a great guy. One wrong word out of Gumpy, and I'll turn legitimate.
Okay, Romeo. Let's tread a measure.
For measure.
The girls today in society go for class. classical poetry.
So
for a wind, their heart one must cope with ease. Aeschylus and Euripides.
One must know Homer and believe me, both Sophocles, also Sappho. Ho,
unless you know Shelley and Keats and Pope. Dainty debbies will call you a dope, but the poet of them all, who will start up simply raving, is the poet people call, the bard of Stratford-on-Avon.
Past cure I am, now reason is past care, and frantic mad with ever more unrest. My thoughts and my discourse, as madmen's are, at random from the truth vainly expressed. For I have sworn thee fair and thought thee bright, who art as black as hell, as dark as night.
Brush up your Shakespeare, start quoting him now. Brush up your Shakespeare, and the women you will wow.
Я порвал со своей так называемой женой, человек, который погряз в кухне, в готовке.
Mr. Khrushchev celebrated his 70th birthday on Saturday, a fair age for a man in a pretty grueling line of business. Mr. K, as well as being a world leader, is a happy family man. The newspapers reported that he celebrated his birthday in high spirits. And one of the ways Mr. K keeps happy is by watching Arkady Rykin, his favorite comedian.
Представляете, как она будет с вами жить? Утром будем работать, вечером будем встречаться, делиться впечатлениями дня. Или мы в театре, или мы в кино, или просто гуляем по набережной. Я смотрю на вас, вы на меня, и так всю жизнь. Зиночка.
It's impassioned, it's dramatic, it's Latin.
It's too darn hot. It's too darn hot. I'd like to sup with my baby tonight. And play the pup with my baby tonight. I'd like to sup with my baby tonight. Play the pup with my baby tonight. But I ain't up to my baby tonight, 'cause it's too darn hot. It's too darn hot. It's too darn hot. It's too darn hot.
BBC Two. Friday night programs continue with Westminster at Work.
And we launch this program at a moment when MPs are really looking for new signposts. They now know when the election will be, they now know what's in the budget, and yet somehow they've got to live through the last 6 months of this parliament. Well, this week, they've been given at least one new talking point.
And that was Sir Alec's surprise decision to hold four by-elections on May the 14th. An act of courage or an act of foolhardiness? That's what MPs were asking, but at any rate it's brought some excitement into the Westminster scene.
A victory for the spirit of British broadcasting.
Here's a house. Here's a door. Windows, one, two, three, four. Ready to knock? Turn the lock. It's play school.
Hello, I'm Virginia.
Hello, I'm Gordon.
Another vice, promiscuity.
According to the Kinsey Report, every average man you know much prefers to take his favorite spot when the temperature is low. When the thermometer goes way up and the weather is sizzling hot, Mr. Adam or his madam is not, 'cause it's too, too, too darn hot. It's too darn hot. It's too.
In a few moments, we shall be joining J.B. Priestley in the first of his new series, Conversations for Tomorrow. The program follows in about half a minute.
Somebody wants to set them off.
A lot of shooting going on out there. More than likely, one of us will lose the man she loves.
In Conversations for Tomorrow, J.B. Priestley entertains two distinguished guests to dinner. This week, they are both Oxford dons. Sir Isaiah Berlin, Cicelli Professor of Social and Political Theory, and A.J. Eyre, Wickham Professor of Logic. As we join them, their host, J.B. Priestley, is starting to talk about the problem of men and machines.
They're obviously very gorgeous, as they would be.
Well, now, what kind of fantasy is this? One imagines some machine originally set up by the three of us, shall we say, in an extremely high-minded way. And then this machine itself issues orders to policeman machines, which are somehow mechanically reproduced. And then our very careful blueprints go wrong in some way, and there's no means of correcting this. This is perfect. But how different is this from human beings, after all? Isn't this a very perfectly good description of a good deal that happens in a good many places? Perhaps not many miles from here?
Was this ambition?
Will you help me decide? Shall we look through that one? No, I don't think so. No. What about this one? The round one? No, I don't feel like looking through a round one today. Well, there's only one left. What about this one?
Morning, Mr. Allsop.
Morning, Mr. Barker. How are you?
Pretty well, thank you.
Very good.
How's the money with you today?
Well, it's going to be short again, I think. We were in the bank yesterday, and we've got a lot of bad money on our books, which we're paying much too much for, and we're trying to get rid of.
Yes.
How are you?
Oh. Well, we weren't very active yesterday. Mm-hmm. We didn't do much at all during the afternoon, although most of the houses did take privileged money. You're short today?
Yes, I want any help you can give me.
I'm afraid I can't give you much help in the way of money as yet, but if we are small buyers of bills, I can take a quarter of a million late March treasuries at 3 21/32.
Yes, I've got some of those. I sold some at 5/8, but I think 21/32 is a fair rate, really. We'll do that. That's done.
Good.
We now wish to express our best wishes for a magnificent opening and the success your brilliant talents deserve. I copied that from a greetings telegram.
Heartiest felicitations. I made that up myself.
BBC Two is now closing down.
This Saturday, Classic Entertainment, to celebrate 25 years of BBC Two, starts with a landmark in television drama.
If you stop talking for a minute...
If I stop talking for 1 minute, there'll be an ugly black silence, deep as the world, and I might fall into it.
Instead of which...
Instead of which, I make a bridge of sound and run like the very devil, because on the other side...
What?
Something better than this.
Now, Minister, the evidence that you're proposing to submit is not only untrue, it is also, which is much more serious, unwise.
So when this next comes up at question time, you want me to tell Parliament that it's their fault that the civil service is too big?
But it's the truth, Minister.
I don't want the truth. I want something I can tell Parliament.
Britain is paying more to the EEC than anybody else. Because everyone else in the EEC hates Britain, that's why. Why must you always be looking for complex economic answers? We want to bleed your crummy little island until it dies of anemia.
Classic BBC Two Entertainment on Saturday night.
And further memories of BBC Two's early years are revived in The Late Show tonight by Andy Shepherd, who looks back on some classic jazz performances of the 60s in Jazz 625. The Late Show at 11:15. Paul Daniels has some more tempting prizes on offer for the couples playing the game where every second counts on BBC One shortly. On two, in 25 minutes, we look at life around the first and probably the most famous motorway services in Britain, which opened on the M1 30 years ago, The Gap. And at a time when on BBC Two we're recalling the early days, we have some classic comedy now with Phil Silvers as Sergeant Bilko.
Yeah!